Glory to God. Hallelujah. We do want to just bless the Lord for another brand new month. Can you believe that we're already in the second month of this brand new year, 2019? We want to welcome you and we want to thank you so much for tuning into Midday Glory. I'm Reverend Gwendolyn Dixon, and I will be your host for the next 20 minutes. Glory to God. We're still on the subject, what God expects of us. Glory to God. So far in the last two or three weeks, or maybe 4 weeks, we've covered what God expects of us as believers, what his word teaches us. He teaches us that we must be doers of his word. The first topic that we've covered was the word teaches us to love one another. John 13, 34 and 35 says, "A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, and that ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if you have loved one to another." The other thing that the word of God teaches us, to love our enemies. Matthew 5:44 says, "But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you." The third thing that the word of God teaches us is to pray one for another. James 5:16 says, "Confess your faults one to another and pray for one another that ye may be healed. The effectual and fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much." And under that topic of to pray for one another, we found seven staggering, astonishing things that God does for us when we do pray for one another. We discussed that when we pray for one another, God answers. When we pray for one another, God heals. When we pray for one another, God opens doors, glory to God. When we pray for one another, God begins to grow us spiritually. We spiritually mature. So today, glory to God, we're going to continue on with the next three staggering, astonishing things that God does for us when we pray for one another. So the fifth one that we discovered is that when we pray for one another, God lifts our burdens, glory to God. Galatians 6:2 said, "Bear ye one another's burdens, and ye so fulfill the law of Christ." Praying is one of the most powerful ways to care for one another, glory to God. When we pray for one another, it allows us to bear the burdens of our brothers and our sisters. God doesn't want us to do it by ourselves. He doesn't want us to do it alone. He has given us brothers and sisters to pray for us. Also ask for prayer from other spiritual-minded, Christ-minded people, glory to God. We don't have to do it by ourselves. The Lord will tell us who we need to seek to ask us to pray. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Another staggering, astonishing thing that we discovered is that when we pray for one another, God humbles us. As I mentioned earlier, I think it was last week or week before last, the Apostle Paul humbly asked for others to pray for him. Romans 15:30 says, "Now I beseech you, brethren, for the Lord Jesus Christ's sake and for the love of the Spirit, that ye strive together with me in your prayers to God for me." Let me tell you, it is so humbling to ask others to pray for us. It's so humbling to admit that we can't do it by ourselves. We just can't do it alone, glory to God. It is humbling to ask for prayer for our children, ask for prayer for our spouses, ask for prayer for our family members, glory to God. Humbling to admit we need God's help at work, glory to God. God promises to bless us when we humble ourselves. In James 4:6, he says, "But he giveth more grace. Wherefore," he said, "God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble." When we humble ourselves and ask others to pray for us, he will give us grace. And when others ask us to pray for them, he gives them grace as well as glory to God. It's the power of prayer. Hallelujah. And the last staggering thing that we're going to discuss when we pray for one another is that God helps us overcome sin. 1 John 5:16-17 says, "If any man see his brother sin, a sin which is not unto death, he shall ask, and he shall give him life for them that sin not unto death." There is no sin. There is a sin unto death. I do not say that he shall pray for it. All unrighteousness is sin, and there is a sin not unto death. Glory to God. If you see a fellow believer sinning in a way that does not lead to death, the Lord tells us that we should pray and that God would give that person life. Glory to God. We have a high assignment from God. God's mercy is renewed to every last one of us every single morning. He is such a faithful God. And now, unlike Christ, when we see a brother or sister in fault, it's easy for us to start judging them. But this is not the time when we should, this is not the time to be judgmental, or it's not the time to be walking around gossiping. This is the time that God is saying, earnestly pray for that individual. Instead of looking down upon them, instead of going around spreading what you know about them, pray for them. Glory to God. We serve a merciful God. When we confess our sins, he is just to forgive us of our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He answers our prayers for others, and he helps them overcome their sins. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So those were the seven staggering, astonishing things that happen when we pray for one another. Now let's get back to what God expects of us as believers. As stated, we discussed the Word of God. It teaches us to love one another. It teaches us to love our enemies. It teaches us to pray for one another. So the fourth one, the one that we're going to discuss now, is the Word of God teaches us to forgive one another. Hallelujah. Forgiving others is a direction from God. Probably before we entered into our relationship with the Lord, before we got into this love thing with the Lord, we thought that forgiving is a choice. And in one sense, it is a choice because God does not make us do anything. But God has been very clear about forgiveness. He has given us specific direction in numerous scriptures in the Bible, all of which can be summed up to just one word, and that word is forgive. Glory to God. God's word says in Mark 11:25, and when ye stand praying, forgive. If ye have ought against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. Glory to God. And then Luke 6:37 says, judge not, and ye shall not be judged. Condemn not, and ye shall not be condemned. We'll forgive, and ye shall be forgiven. Glory to God. God is saying that it's at our own best interest that we do forgive. You see, he's not talking about what is in the best interest of the person who needs to be forgiven. I always say that when we stand before God at that judgment day, he's not going to ask me, what did you do to me? But he's going to ask me, what did I do to you? Glory to God. It's important that we always, no matter where we are, that we represent Christ. We are the ones who God is trying to protect. We are the ones who receive the most benefit from forgiveness, not the other person. Glory to God. A spirit of unforgiveness complicates and it compromises our daily walk with God. Hear what I'm saying now. Forgiving others releases us from anger, and it allows us to receive the healing that we need. Hallelujah. The whole reason God has given us specific direction is because he does not want anything to stand between our relationship, between him and us. Glory to God. He loves us beyond our comprehension. Glory to God. If we could only understand the deep, unconditional love that Christ has for us, and we could understand the importance of truly forgiving. Forgiving others spares us from the consequences of living in an unforgiving heart. Forgiving others does not carry with it a single decision that we need to ponder. God has not qualified one sin as being more grievous to him than another, and he has not qualified one sin committed against us as warranting forgiveness and another not. As an example, God is not saying if a person lies to you or steals from you that you should forgive him. But if they abuse you or abuse your child, you can hold that in unforgiveness. He's not saying this. He is saying to forgive everyone of everything, glory to God, always, and do it immediately. Don't wait. Why? Because this next second is not promised to us, glory to God. Ephesians 4:26 says, be ye angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. It's okay to get angry, but don't stay angry. Unforgiveness is anger, glory to God. Forgiving others often takes time. It often takes time. We have to listen with our heart and be open to anything that the Lord might say to us. We have to get into his very presence. We have to get into worship with him so he can deliver us from the anger and the hurt that may have caused us not to want to forgive. The Lord loves all of us, glory to God, even the one that has caused the pain. He doesn't like the actions that we have chosen, but he loves us. He gives us brand new mercies every morning because of his deep love abiding for that. He abides for us, glory to God. Once we can recognize that the Lord truly loves us all, no matter what we've done, it would allow us to have a change of heart. We would then choose to forgive. When we allow unforgiveness to linger, life, anger, resentment, fear, misunderstanding, and confusion remains on the inside of us. It remains in our heart. But when we let go, we feel our heart softening. It's such a fantastic feeling to give everything to the Lord, to surrender all to him, to let him have full control of our lives. It brings peace in our hearts. Glory be to his name. Hallelujah. We have a divine example for forgiving Christ, for forgiving others. When God knew that man needed forgiveness, so he sent his only son to deliver us of all mankind from the eternal consequences of their sins. And 1 John 4:9-10 says, "And this was manifested the love of God towards us, because that God sent his only begotten son into the world that we might live through him." And then Galatians 3:13 says, "Forbearing one another and forgiving one another. If any man have quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye." Glory to God. Jesus not only had the power to forgive, but to grant us the ability to forgive others just as we have been forgiven. Glory to God. Forgiving others often starts as a decision of a surrender. It's an act of our will. This surrender invites God to begin working in our lives in a deeper level, allowing God to heal us. We need to fully forgive from our hearts. We must be open to forgiveness and reconciliation, glory to God. We have to remember forgiveness does not justify the deed or the person. It does not provide God's forgiveness in their actions, because only God can do that. While nothing can undo the past, we can do something about the condition of our own present time right now and our future. You see, when we forgive others, it makes a way for our own healing to begin. Hallelujah. Matthew 6:14 says, if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. And then Ephesians 4:32 says, and be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forbearing one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. If we as Christians are not willing to forgive others, we will find our fellowship with God very hindered. Matthew 6:15 says, but if you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. And then Hebrews 12:14-15 says, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man can see the Lord, looking diligently lest any man fail of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. 2 John 1:8 says, look up to yourselves, that we lose not those things we have wrought, but that we receive a full reward. God commands us to forgive. We must make a conscious choice to obey God and to forgive. It's the word of God. Just want to remind us of this powerful scripture that changed my life. Why? Because it's the word of God. So I desire to do his will, not my will, but his will be done in my life. That scripture that I've already read, I want to read it again before we go into prayer, is Matthew 5:44. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them that despitefully use you and persecute you. If we will let go, if we will let God, surrender all to him, we will have a life of peace, a life of joy, and a life of happiness. Glory be to God. Let us pray. Glory to God.
Ooh, glory to God. You are the Most High God. You are the Almighty God. You are the good shepherd. You are Alpha and Omega. You are the beginning, Almighty God, and you are the end. You are the great I am. You are the Lamb of God. You are the King of kings. You are Lord over all. You are the Messiah. Hallelujah. You are Emmanuel. You are the mighty one, Lord God. And we worship you today, Lord God. Hallelujah. Your word is truth, Lord God. Your word, Father God, just renovates on the inside of us, Lord God. And we just want to say, Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God. You are our Father which art in heaven. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done in earth as it is in heaven, Almighty God. Give us this day our daily bread, God. Forgive us of all of our debts as we forgive our debtors. And God, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, Lord God. For you are the kingdom, you are the power, and you are the glory forever. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to your name, God. Heavenly Father, we come on this day, God, to give you glory. We come to give you honor. We come to give you praise. You are the Christ. You are the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. You are our Redeemer. You are our fortress, Lord God. You are our Redeemer, our fortress, and our deliverer, Lord God. We cast all of our cares upon you, Lord God. We can do nothing on our own, Lord God. You created the heavens and the earth. You are above all everything, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Greater is you, Almighty God, that is in us than the things that are out there in the world, Lord God. Thank you for the Holy Spirit, oh God, that abides on the inside of us. Thank you, Almighty God, for your unconditional love. Thank you for teaching us to love one another, Lord God. Thank you for teaching us to love our enemies, Almighty God. Thank you for teaching us to pray for one another, Lord God, for forgiving one another, Lord God. Hallelujah. God, when we reach that point, God, we can feel the scales and the weight falling off of us in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, Lord God, you have made everything available to us, oh God, that we can be doers of your word. We honor you today, God, and we desire, Almighty God, to do your will, Lord God. We desire, Almighty God, to please you in every last. Everything, God, belongs to you. We have nothing, Lord God. You have given us everything that pertains to life and godliness, Almighty God. You bless us with spiritual blessings in the heavenly realm, Lord God. You've restored glory to us, Almighty God. You restore life eternally to us, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, Almighty God, for all that you have done. We thank you, oh God, because we know that you will be with us always. You will never leave us nor forsake us. You are the God Almighty. Your life is joy and peace. Hallelujah. Your life is a life of righteousness, oh God, which gives us right standing with you. Hallelujah. We are justified. You have removed sin for us as far as the east is from the west, Lord God. You have chosen us before the foundation of the world, Lord God. You said that we should be holy, consecrated, and set apart for you, Almighty God. Hallelujah. You said, Lord God, that we are blameless in your sight. You, Father God, foreordained us. You adopted us as your children. Hallelujah. Thank you for your mercy and your grace, Almighty God. Thank you for redemption and deliverance, oh God, and for salvation, God. Thank you for the blood that you shed on Calvary, Lord God, just for us, God, just for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Almighty God, for forgiving us, God, with all that you have given unto us, all our shortcomings, God, all of our willingness to sin. We should be equipped to forgive others, God. You've given us everything, God. You are righteous, God. You are, Father God, you love us beyond measure, Lord God. You give us spiritual wisdom and knowledge and discernment, Lord God. Thank you for making us into your image. We must carry out your will, Almighty God, for our lives. We speak in the name of Jesus to every hindering spirit that tried to rise up against us. It must go in the mighty name of Jesus. We reject every foul spirit, hallelujah, from our lives in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We have the mind of Christ, glory to God, to do your will. We have strength and power from you, Almighty God, hallelujah. You provided all the tools, all the spiritual tools we need, oh Lord God, to be able, Lord God, to be steadfast and abandoned in your word, Lord God. We have power from on high to stand against every dot of the evil, Lord God, every scheme that the devil may try, Lord God, hallelujah. We plead the blood of Jesus right now, God. We want to be dressed in your armor, Lord God. We want, Father God, to have our lions girded up with truth, Father God, wrapped around our waist, the breastplate of righteousness, Father God, always in place, oh God. Our feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, oh God, a shield of faith, oh God, to put out the flaming arrows of the devil, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. And then we thank you for the helmet of salvation. We thank you for the sword of the Spirit, which is your word, God. We praise you, Almighty God, and we magnify you. We glorify you. We thank you for putting us Father, put in us the desire to do your will, Lord God. We know we have the power from on high. We can do all things through you, Almighty God. We bless your name, God. We honor your name, God. We're so grateful for this subject, what you expect of us, Lord God. We know, God, that you expect greatness. We know, God, that you expect us to do your will, Lord God. There is nothing too hard for the Lord. And, God, we desire, Lord God, to walk by faith and not by sight. We desire, Almighty God, to be a doer of your word and not a hearer only, Lord God. Activate the word in us, Lord God, as we, Father God, we will do the will of our Father. We thank you and we praise you, Father God. And this is your servant's prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Our hearts and our souls says amen, amen, and amen. Glory to God. I just want to share that I am having such a great time with God on this subject. What does God expect of us? Now, when God gave me this subject at the end of January, I didn't know where he was going with this thing. I didn't know what he was going to tell me what he expected of us. But what he expects of us is not difficult. We know the Bible. We are knowledgeable of the Bible. We pray for the anointing to fall upon us, and it is not a difficult thing to just do the will of our Father. It gives us peace. It gives us joy, and it gives us happiness. God bless you. Share this with somebody. Go back on Spreaker.com. Go back and read. Oh, I think we're in part 5 today or whatever. Go back and read every last one of them. Keep it going. Keep it going. Keep it going. May God richly bless you in Jesus' name. Bye-bye.